A huge question about the Fermi paradox is that can the "are we alone" question be answered without ever discovering evidence of intelligent alien life? After all, our searches so far have turned up nothing conclusive, and as far as we can tell, we see only the great silence. So can we answer the "are we alone" question without SETI ever detecting anything? The answer is yes, sort of, conditionally. Actual observation of alien civilizations in general is rather limited. You can search the galaxy, certainly, and to a degree the nearby local group of galaxies, but the further you go out, the harder it is to detect anything. Signals get too weak, observations of exoplanets typically not possible at great distances, and so on. You'd need alien astroengineering on a galactic scale to see it, typically a Kardashev Type 3 civilization encasing huge amounts of stars in a galaxy inside Dyson spheres, or reddening galaxies unnaturally by kicking out or altering dangerous stars to avoid the supernova problem. But so far, we've seen nothing of this. Beyond that, you're simply looking at galaxies too far back in time, from a period when they didn't yet have enough heavy elements to form planets and time for life to arise. This is the brick wall of time. So unless an alien civilization does something on an enormous and perhaps impractical scale, and does it closely, we are generally limited to mostly searching our own galaxy. That's not necessarily a bad thing. This galaxy has on the order of 200 billion stars, most of them ostensibly habitable, so we have plenty of real estate to search. But to date, no one's seen anything truly compelling that would indicate an alien presence in this galaxy. It's worth pointing out here, however, that we've only just barely looked. There are several aspects of this. Have we searched every star in the galaxy for radio signals? No, nothing close. Have we searched for other bio and technosignatures? No, we've only barely just started, if that. And then one really important question. Have we looked long enough to see anything? Not by a long shot. Alien civilizations may work on much longer timescales than we do, are so transient we just miss them. As a result, we don't really know if there is a great silence, much less the reason for it. There are some future ways to address these problems, such as all-sky SETI monitoring coming in the future, but instead of a great silence, we may still be suffering from a great deafness. That said, there will come a time where the great silence could assert itself very strongly. If we spend the next few centuries doing SETI searches and we never find anything, then it will become less likely at some point that we ever will. There could come a point in the future where the silence will become deafening. And that will lead us to a question. Are there other ways we can explore regarding alien life to try to come to a reasonable assumption that life in the universe and civilizations are common or rare? The answer is yes, and there are three ways, and all three potentially could reasonably solve the Fermi paradox without directly detecting intelligent alien civilizations. Yes, and any of the three could happen in the next human lifetime, but not definitively. To definitively answer the question, you need the detection of an alien civilization directly. The first way is solving the question of how abiogenesis worked on Earth. If you can figure out the mechanism, you can determine if the process is difficult to nearly impossible, or if it's straightforward and easy. Recent evidence, interestingly, is moving towards the easier-than-we-thought side of things, specifically in the areas of RNA genesis and symbiosis being a possible factor in the leap from simple to complex life. Should the process prove easy and repeatable, we can look at the conditions required, and if they seem common, then we can reasonably assume that the universe teems with microbial life at the very least, and that civilizations occasionally arising from that are probable since we self-proved the concept. We're here, and we prove that nature can produce intelligence and civilizations, and we're likely just one member of a population of like occurrences. The second way is to discover independent life somewhere else in the solar system, whether that be subterranean Mars, Europa, Enceladus, the upper cloud decks of Venus, and so on. If you found microbial life, or even macrofauna, in an ice shell moon ocean that's genetically distinct from Earth, then you have the same effect. If life arose twice in the same star system, then it's very likely everywhere throughout the universe. Again, this does not speak to civilizations, it just makes them more probable to occur. They might be rare, but nature hates a one-off. There are almost always other examples of something occurring in the universe. That goes for intelligence too. The path to investigating the first two ways is clear. Research, study, sample, and find out. Go see if Mars has life. Go into the lab and crack abiogenesis. Those are possible, and indeed scientists are hard at work on both fronts. But there is another, and while it's more of a long shot as far as proving it, there may be a way, and there is already an indicator that it may be the case. It's the infinite universe, and if it turns out to be the case, then it becomes impossible for us to be alone. And there must necessarily be countless civilizations out there. The only problem is that they are probably so distant we'll never know about them. We could only just strongly assume that they exist. The basis for this is that we don't actually know how large the universe actually is. We can see only our own observable universe, which is basically a bubble of the larger whole. Some theories suggest that only a small amount of the universe lies beyond the observable border, but others suggest that it could be very large, and it's possible that it's infinitely so. Infinity, by its very nature, opens up a certain reality that anything that can happen will tend to happen, and that goes for civilizations. Since intelligence is possible and we represent it, it becomes impossible for there not to be other occurrences of civilizations. They would be infinite in number. But this also means necessarily that some of those civilizations will be almost identical to our own, to the point of being doppelgangers. But there would also be truly alien civilizations that too have doppelgangers of their own, and so on. It would be a universe where if you traveled far enough, you'd come across an almost identical twin to Earth, and you'd no doubt encounter many civilizations in between that are nothing like us. In other words, an infinite universe dissolves the Fermi Paradox and dictates that there must be others out there. You may never see them or interact with them, but it's a certainty that they will be there. So, do we have any indicators that the universe is infinite? Actually, we might. And as our understanding of cosmology continues to improve, we may someday be able to determine it definitively. No one yet knows, but one aspect of this is the overall geometry of the universe. We know that the Big Bang happened 13.8 billion years ago, and due to the expansion of the universe, our bubble has a radius of about 46.1 billion light years. That's huge. But there are indications that the universe overall may be a great deal larger, or even infinite. So this brings in the overall geometry of the universe. If as a whole, if it were positively or negatively curved, two beams of light, or say a pair of railroad tracks extending a huge length of the total universe, they would either converge and meet, or diverge at some distant point. This doesn't seem to be the case. Two parallel beams of light will never curve and meet or diverge. They just keep on going as you'd expect them to. This means that our universe appears to be spatially flat on its largest scales. That allows for some limits to be set on the lower end of the size of the actual universe, and this is where it gets crazy. It needs to be on the order of 37 trillion light years in diameter. This means that the observable universe is only a very, very tiny bubble indeed, and if the universe continues on, much like the part that we can see, which it very likely does, this dramatically increases the chances for intelligent life somewhere in the universe. We just can't ever see if it's out there. But at that point, it's almost certainly there, or there's something very strange indeed going on with this universe. But that's not infinite necessarily, the point at which we can consider alien life a certainty. But there are some clues here that even at those scales, we may still be underestimating the size of the universe. And this is where the mysteries start. We don't really know certain key conditions and features of the Big Bang to estimate just how large the universe is, and indeed, if it's infinite. This requires a better understanding of cosmic inflation, and while that's not entirely clear now, there may come a time when we understand it. Or we may never have enough of a bubble of the universe to understand it completely. We just don't know. The point is, though, the larger the universe, the more chances you have for the development of alien intelligent life. The odds grow and grow until they simply become overwhelming. This is why a lot of scientists, though there are dissenters, suspect that alien life, even intelligent alien life, must be out there somewhere. The numbers are just too stacked against it not being there. And it gets increasingly worse if the universe is so much more enormous than what we currently see. With an infinite universe, it becomes a certainty, and the Fermi Paradox reduces down to a single solution. Aliens exist, but in the future, after spending centuries looking for them when we still see nothing, then the solution reduces to all alien civilizations are simply too far away to detect or interact with. And while it may seem disappointing, it pays to remember that there are strange things about this universe we do not understand, such things as spooky action at a distance, that do exist, hinting perhaps at unknown physics that we may someday unlock, allowing for things that we can't currently envision. And that too is a solution to the Fermi Paradox, that we simply didn't have a complete enough understanding of physics to even notice the aliens. Thanks for listening. I am science fiction author and futurist John Michael Godier, currently addressing the sleep crowd. One of the most common questions I get in the comments is regarding the content I fall asleep to. This varies and used to involve AM radio, but YouTube content not so much, as I get too interested in the subject matter. Rather, I watch YouTube channels fully awake and engaged. But to fall asleep, well, I'm about to turn 47, so TV that was in rerun in the early 1980s when I was a little kid does it for me. I can't last 10 minutes after hearing the theme songs from Taxi, MASH, or even the much later Cheers without happily drifting off. And there's always reading in bed, which does it too. And be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channels for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.